leave a fucking like. No, I'm just fucking with you guys. But I think you will like today's video, nonetheless. I had a call with Red Kiwis, and I'm uploading the full call. I believe he's doing about the same, too, the full call on each of our channels. And we talked about the tryhard and trickshotter perspectives on fast lasting, is what it's called, but even other things, generic, in the Call of Duty community, and how things are and what we want to change from each of our sides. And it was a really fun call to have. He's a great guy to talk to, really good dude. His link is going to be in the description if you'd like to check him out. I highly suggest you do. Like I said, he's a great guy. I think you'll enjoy his videos and what he creates. And I hope you enjoy this. Do not leave any hate. This video is not about hate. It is about seeing the issue from both sides. As you guys know, there's two sides to any story, or even more possibly, and we wanted to bring you guys both of those, and we want you to see it from each perspective. And I understand their perspective, and he understands mine, and I think we get a lot of what we need to say covered in this video, and that's really all I can tell you about it. I hope you just watch the full thing or listen to it. It is long, and I apologize. We talked for a while and talked about a lot of things, but I think you will enjoy it if you do give it the time. Thank you guys, though, for checking it out, and I will see you all later.
To cover, like, the whole lobby? Like, it wasn't just, like, one...
It was four people. Yeah, we had...
Yeah. That is not acceptable. To the point, I think, where Moonzy had it, it wasn't at that big of a deal, which it shouldn't be okay. Like I said in my video, I don't do it myself. Like, I don't think... You know, I'm not really defending it, but if it came down to the point where if Moonzy was going to get kicked for this, that it would be just, like, way over-exaggerated and just, like, it's really not that big of a deal. This situation, as all these other people are doing in the COD community, they're setting up clips, they're using EB to hit trick shots, you know, they're basically just faking clips all over the place. Basically, every team that's not Red has players that fakes clips and uses EB, and it's really corrupt, and it's really,
I've seen a lot of, like I said, I've played Search for a long, long time. And I've been in Black Ops 2 for 3 years alone, just because Ghost was crap, and then Advanced Warfare got boring after a few months, but I've seen a lot of setups, I've seen a lot, and the issue that I point out, I don't make these videos most of the time, because, like, I think I have 1,380 videos created. I've been doing it for 5 years, almost six. And I think I've made four or three. Only involving members of either Red, FaZe, and then sometimes Obey and another big team like that. And it's not because, it's like, some people are like, oh, you get more views for that because you're calling out a bigger team. It's not that in the sense that those people, although they do get more views when you make a video about it, set the standards for what the community is going to be doing. Like, if I told people, and I've done this before, like in MW3, I told people it was bullshit to use Sitrep Pro because it was such an absurdly easy perk to get kills with because anyone could hear from 50 yards away if you were coming. So we tell people, okay, don't use Sitrep Pro. And the legitimate people that are, like, kind of respectable, until it became unbelievable and you kind of had to use it, would stay away from it. And it's like, that's kind of where you look at the bigger teams. If you say, all right, fast lasting isn't cool because by taking away four members of the team, and essentially being able to watch where anyone else is on that team as well to get killed, to kill them really quick, that creates a chance for you to get a trick shot. Granted, it is a shot against people that are playing against you way quicker and easier in comparison to not doing it. So by doing that, it's like all of a sudden you have, and people are like, it doesn't help your odds of hitting a shot. You have a chance to hit a shot, and most people don't get that as often as you will. So by that means, your chance of hitting a shot is increased maybe 15-fold. In comparison to someone that's maybe just playing with a clear out, or even just playing in a normal six-man group that are just trying to kill the people themselves.
Sure. No, I agree. But my main point in the video was that Moonzy really shouldn't be getting, like, the amount of hate he's getting. Like, the thing that I thought I was really frustrated, because you make these videos, and then they just get fucking fuck tons of hate, and then it's just stuck with them.
That's actually really surprising. I mean, I pointed out who was in the party, and I didn't, like, emphasize Moonzy over anyone else.
Right.
I mean, Red's probably the biggest team out of that group, for sure, I think. Mm-hmm. And I'm friends with, I guess, Xant. I've been friends with him for a long time. He was on the editor team. And Rye, I've been friends with for a long time. And I'm friends with some of the guys on FaZe as well that I've known. Just, I mean, from doing YouTube for so long, you meet these people, you know?
Yeah.
And
yeah, and
I always give these guys respect because they've been working at it for a long time. They work hard and put that in. But then when you see people, Moonzy or anyone else in that party, that has reached any type of success in the community, that's flooded with people that are, as you said, even cheating to like using fake shots and all sorts of stuff to get attention. It sets a bad example for anyone that's actually attempting to do it legit, especially if they take up a roster spot. And I'm not saying he is. Like I said, his example, I never asked for him to get kicked. I never messaged Scars or Rye and said, hey, make sure this guy doesn't stay on the team, get him off. Didn't say any of that stuff. But if people are doing something very severe, and what he was doing, like you said, and I agree, it's not that big of a deal because it's very easy to just say, all right, I won't do this anymore, and then set the right example. Right.
But there's, yeah, that's another thing. You can always just say, yeah, I won't do this again, whatever. When usually they'll most likely end up doing it. But what I was saying in my video, like my main point was that this shouldn't be treated as, you know, crazy as it is right now. Because in my mind, when I, like, I don't do this, I'm not very familiar with FastLass, but when, you know, when I think of it in my head, I don't really see it as cheating as long as there's just, like, one or two spots on the other team. But like you said, it's like you're having a VSAT. And when you're trying to play for the game itself, like you're playing S&D to, like, win
or yeah, trying to win
whatever, then, you know, it's not fair to you guys, and I totally understand that. But in the trick-shotting side of the community, like, I understand where you're coming from. Like, it's cheating. Like, I'm trying to fucking win, and you're doing this, and this is fucked up.
Well, dude, I mean, even if you're not trying to win, like, in the video, I jumped off every time. I didn't try to win. I just didn't give them a shot because I didn't think they deserved to take a shot on something that they were doing. When they were doing that, I didn't think they deserved to have a shot. But,
well, you also wanted to get footage. That's why you were killing yourself, I assume, right?
I mean, getting footage, I can do that while being alive. That's not
I know, but it's easier to do that when you're just killing yourself. Like,
you I did that specifically to not give him a shot. that was me being a dick. Well, okay. That was me being like, all right, you guys are giving me four teammates that aren't playing. I'm not letting you have a shot. That's bullshit.
Yeah. So I agree with you totally. Like, I don't do it specifically because, you know, like, when trickshotting first started, it got big because you're hitting shit on people that are trying to kill you, and this is, like, impossible. Like, how the fuck did you do that? Like, you just killed somebody that was, you know, like, this is crazy. Like, what is this? And then, you know, people wanted to up the ante, and then people started setting up clips. And this is when, on Modern Warfare 2, everybody started to set up. Like, even FaZe members, where they just didn't fucking care. Like, they would just go straight in, and they'd be like, yo, be chill, like, fucking chill lobby, you know, whatever, no scope rule only, stand down there and just no scope, you know, whatever. It's just, it was stupid. And then,
oh yeah, it's changed a lot. Changed a lot over the years.
And then Banks, Rain, and Lucid actually made a video of a Skype convo that they had right before the release of Black Ops 2, and they said, you know, this has got to stop. Like, this is so bad. Like, the trickshotting community is corrupt. Their setting up is all over the place. Like, this is just not acceptable. Like, this is not how it was when we first started, and we've just gotten carried away with it. We've been trying so hard to hit the craziest trick shots, and it's just, so when Black Ops 2 came out, everybody was just like, you know what, you're right, let's just give it a chance, let's stop setting up, let's play the game legit on a brand new game. And then Black Ops 2 actually lasted us fucking 3 years. So we played MW2 before for 3 years, and now we're playing Black Ops 2 for 3 years, and the community is just recycling itself. But now I feel like it's even worse because we have people that are using EB, setting up clips, and fucking getting in these big teams with just fake trick shots, you know, fake match bonus, whatever. It's just, it's so bad. I think it's really stupid when the whole point originally was to hit shots on randoms, on people that were trying to win, and then you're hitting this crazy shot on, you know, it's hard to get. Like, it's really hard to hit a shot, and that was the whole point.
Yeah, that's what made it good, of course.
With a snap of a fucking finger, you could shoot and kill somebody. It's just the fact that if you're able to perform the shot, like, it's just so pointless. That's why everybody's getting so bored of trickshotting. And when Black Ops 3 comes out, I was actually going to make a video just similar to how Banks and Rain did 3 years ago. And I was going to get in a call with all the big leaders in the trickshot community saying, like, listen, if we want to keep this going, like, we can't, you guys need to, like, if you see anybody signing up on Black Ops 3, you need to fucking kick them, or, you know, whatever. Like, you just need to fucking kick them on Black Ops 3. Like, we cannot have that. Like, no setting up. Nothing. Like, that's fucking retarded. Like, I think the trickshotting community is probably the worst it's ever been, even back in 2012 when it was, like, really bad.
Oh, but it's super active. There's no question there. If you look at trickshotters that have, like, a sub count of, Like, typically for a YouTuber in my situation, a 10% view count to sub ratio is pretty solid, which means if I have like 170 now, getting 17,000 views within the first 24 hours is pretty good. Trickshotters usually blow that away. They usually have like 20 to 25%.
Yeah, we have like a cult following for
sure.
So
it's super active.
It's just, that's the thing though, like it's so, like people just get carried away. Like it's so big and massive. And there's people, this is what also pisses me off, there's people that started trickshotting like last year. And I also brought this up in my video, in free-for-all, you'll be playing free, like normal people can't play free-for-all anymore because it's turned into a trickshotting lobby every fucking free-for-all game.
Oh, yeah, everyone snipes in it for sure.
Yeah, like you cannot play free-for-all legitly because everybody's just trying to hit a trick shot at
But I don't think that hurts it. Like, okay, so if even if they're sniping, that's the difference where the fast lasting, it's separate. Because by fast lasting, you're decreasing, or you're hurting the way that the person you're playing against, which is just a random player in the game, can actually play the game. Because they no longer have 2 to 4 teammates. They're just not there.
No, yeah, no, I totally agree.
But in free-for-all, you can still shoot anyone. Even if they're sniping, it's fine. I could use an MSMC, or I could use an M8 or whatever. Or
no,
I could
yeah,
use a sniper
no.
myself.
No, that's what I'm saying. I wasn't talking about that. My point of free-for-all is that when you're trying to hit a trick shot, this is coming from the trick-shotting community. Like, this is where, like, when Rain first started making free-for-all videos, he wouldn't allow clips to be usable if somebody else was trickshotting with you in that lobby, because then it would be 29-29.
I do remember that, yeah.
And it just looks ugly and whatever, like you could have hit that on another trickshotter or whatever. But now everybody, the whole lobby will just be 29-29-29-29. Every single person will have 29. And they'll all be trickshotting. It'll be like a private match lobby, just running around fucking trickshotting. Like,
yeah.
That is cheating to me. I think that's stupid because everybody's just trickshotting. Nobody's trying to kill you. Like, you could go for an infinite amount of tries for 5 minutes left of the game and just hit something. Like, so many, that's why there's so many free-for-all trickshotters. You see these 29 lobby clips. And I think that's way more cheating than the VSAT thing, or the fast-lasting thing. But I do agree with you. I mean, this is why I don't do it. But I know that there's people in the community that do it. But, like, my point in the video was, you know, if Moonzy was going to get kicked for this, then it would just be fucking outrageous. But I know you didn't say that. But a lot of people are saying, like, commenting on his videos or just commenting all over the place, why the fuck is Moonzy in fucking red? Like, he should be fucking kicked. Like, what the fuck is this? Like, you know, it's
You should explain this, though, as well. Because how do you fake a clip? Do you mean by editing purposes?
You can do that. Like, you can literally, there's, like, match bonus overlays you can fucking add.
Oh,
like,
okay.
So there's that, but then there's also, like, modding. Like, you could have aimbot EB or explosive bullets. Basically, explosive bullets is, like, you could have anybody, like, it doesn't even have to be set up or anything. The guy could just be in the middle of the map, and as long as you shoot in, like, kind of the same area, it'll kill him. Like, that's what, because the bullet, like, explodes. Like, it doesn't physically explode, but, like, that's what the mechanics of the game do, and it just kills him.
All right.
So it's, like, it's basically like aimbot in a sense, but it looks real because you're shooting in the same general area where the guy is.
Yeah.
But so that's where, but it's gotten to the point where people can kind of tell where, like, what EB, like, what clips are EB and what aren't. So, I don't know. Like, but when
it's Black hard, I mean, I've seen a lot of edits that are definitely faked clips, but
oh, yeah,
they look very real. They look
Oh, believe me.
The editors are good. they're really good.
No, that's another thing too. Like, that's
something. They've improved over the years.
Yeah. What was I trying to say?
It's not iMovie.
Oh,
anymore.
Yeah. When Black Ops 3 comes out, it'll be a total game changer because what Red is going to do specifically, I don't know about any of the other teams, but what we're going to do specifically is we're going to do newer generation consoles only for trickshotting, because on the older consoles you could just mod whatever the fuck, like it doesn't it doesn't even matter. So we were like, okay, well, if we go newer consoles, this will just eliminate any way of faking clips, like, you know what I mean? So that's good. So we're going to do that for PS4 and Xbox One, but mainly everybody's just going to be playing PS4. But that's something I have to talk about in that one video I was talking about. But I just think the COD community is so corrupt. And I'm glad that you make videos, like, you know, exposing people, setting up, and, like, doing this scummy shit. Like, I don't necessarily agree with fast lasting, but I don't see it as cheating. But in your sense, It is cheating because, you know, you're trying to fucking play the game and you don't.
I mean, even in a trick shotter standard. I mean, like I said,
I mean, it's easier to have fast last than it is to actually get to last legitimately. But
yeah, I mean, if you get 10 attempts for every one attempt that someone without doing it is doing it, that increases your odds huge.
Yeah.
So is it fair for someone that doesn't do that, like yourself maybe, that except a smaller channel that wants to attempt to get onto Red or Obey or whatever team they're going for, FaZe, whatever, if they don't do it and then they go up against someone that has been doing it for like months on end trying to collect clips?
Believe me, it's from your standpoint, it's quite the opposite of what you, like, I, like, the lower guys are the ones that are faking clips more than the bigger
Oh,
guys.
Yeah, no, I guarantee
like,
it.
Like, it is so bad, like what... That's another, like, because that's why I find this so, like, fucking crazy, because Moonzy, like, what he was doing is nowhere near, like, I think...
No, it's not.
Red and FaZe is, like, the two top teams, like, they're, like, people in Red, sure, they'll do, like, two box or whatever, but, like, these people under, like, in these other teams, they fake fucking everything. Like, these people trying to get into teams, they fake everything. You will rarely see a six-man trying to, like, hit legit clips nowadays, like... It sucks. Like, it's fucking gay, like, to be honest. Like, if you do see a six-man, it's just people that aren't in teams. Like, they'll just be, like, solo trick shotters. Or you'll have, like, the... Once in a while, you'll have somebody in, like, some team or whatever. But they will be, like... It's just, like, these people in these lower teams, they just fake and set up every shot. And that's why it's really, really stupid. And it's really corrupt. But I think going to newer generations... for of consoles, when Black Ops 3 comes out, it's going to eliminate all that.
Yeah, I mean, in comparison to the people that do way, way more, the fast lasting isn't as bad. I still put it in the bad category, but yeah, it's closer to the middle of the line. But it's not like, yeah, I understand, it's not like an auto-aim bot. You jump off the map, shoot through the floor, get like three kills. Like, oh, so amazing.
yeah, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I play it all the time.
That's my point of the video. And in the beginning when I said, oh, it's another fucking idiot, you know, exposing just to get money and views, that was a joke, like satire, clearly. Like, I wasn't trying to, you know, bash on you or whatever. Because
I've heard Saw Trust,
I was kind of more of a shot at Saw Trust. I don't know if you know who the fuck that
is. People have linked me his videos. I don't really know him at
his
all.
His videos are just horrid, to be honest. Like, your videos are much more educational than his videos. His videos are just, like, they're just fucking stupid, but...
I focus more on the problem that if people do fake clips to get on a legit team, and I mean much more so than the fast lasting thing, like you had mentioned,
right,
that they're taking up a roster spot from someone that has worked hard and hit a legit clip, even though that is, like you said, very rare nowadays, people still do it, I'm sure, and they work toward doing it. I play against a lot of trick shotters all the time because I play so much search that I know there are legit people that are going for shots because I'm the one that makes sure they don't do it. But yeah, it's like I my goal is to not let them hit that, and they get mad at me, which is funny for me. It makes for good YouTube videos,
yeah,
for me, but also
really good trolling video.
For the fact that if you can hit me in a trick shot, that's really fucking good. I'm someone that will try very hard against you with an M8 or MSMC, and if you hit a shot against me, that means it's a real shot. I'm not like sitting there letting you shoot me.
That's how it was in 2011 and 2010 and even a little bit in 2013. But then once we hit that 2014, like closer to the end of 2014, and now 2015 is just so fucking bad. Like, that's why there's like Rain and them, like, they don't even trick shot anymore. Like, they don't have fun doing it because it's just like the shots they go for legit shit, but their shots that they go for, just because they're not setting up and stuff, it's so low in comparison to these other trick shotters that are faking clips and going for the craziest shit possible. Like, they just get made fun of, like, when they trick shot because people think they're so bad.
And it takes a while, too. It takes much longer, obviously.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure. But that's another thing. I mean, free-for-all trick shotting, like I said, I feel like that is more so cheating clips than fast-lasting. That's just my opinion, and I know there's going to be a lot of people out there that are just like, well, fucking, who cares, dude? Like, 29 lobbies, like, it's not like you're faking clips or anything. Like,
well, that was a really big surprise to me. People are like, you care, and it's 2015.
Yeah,
it's like,
that's so
like, I don't understand.
Stupid.
The fact that it's 2015, the year doesn't make the difference on whether or not something is legit,
dude,
or people or people are... It's like, because it's this year, apparently, it's okay to fuck around and do things that are not really good. It's like, I don't think so. I mean...
Yeah, it's so dumb. That whole thing, like, wow, you fucking care in 2015. You're a fucking loser. Like, what do you mean I care in 2015? Like, this is YouTube. Like, I do this for, like, you know, like, a hobby and a job. Like, what are you talking about? Like,
and most people don't know that how Trickshotting even started. And it was like you said.
Exactly.
There's so many
people that just started and they don't get it. Like, they're like, what do you fucking mean? Like, who fucking cares? Stop trying to change it. Like, this is how it is. No, it's not how it is. Like, it's ruined right now. And you just started, so you have no idea. Like, it used to be so much more fun and so much more just, yeah. Like,
it came from good snipers. Like, Trickshotters were really good snipers without doing a shot. And that's how they could get to last. Like, it wasn't a clear out. It wasn't some modder. It wasn't someone hitting other people offline. It wasn't fast lasting. It was Trickshotters with, like, 2.5 KDs that would just dick on other people. Yeah. And then they'd just be the last alive against a person. And they want to make it interesting.
I mean, clear outers, they weren't.
I don't have a problem with clear outs either. That's a normal player playing the game.
They weren't invented until, like, I think Black Ops 2, because people were just like, dude, I can't fucking get to last on Black Ops 2. This is gay. So
yeah, nothing wrong with that either. I mean, it's like it's a normal people, but, are like people will compare it, which is crazy. Like,
I totally agree.
It's
crazy too. But my whole point of the video when I made it was basically like, dude, like comparing fast lasting to setting up or faking clips or 29 lobbies in free-for-all, this is at the bottom of the list. This is not even in comparison to these other things. And what a lot of people are frustrated with you specifically in the trickshot community is because, like, you're not a part of this, and then you're bringing all this hate to these other trickshotters, and it's just like I could, like, I'll be a fucking COD YouTuber and then I'll go on FIFA. And then I'll find somebody doing something fucking stupid on FIFA, and I'll make a video about it. And then the whole FIFA community is just like, dude, but you don't understand. Like, a lot of people do this, and it's not as bad as this or whatever. Like, and I know fast lasting it's still in the bad category, and I see why people look down on it. And I'm not really defending it. I'm just saying, like,
it's not as bad.
It's not even close.
Yeah.
And it really shouldn't be as big of a problem as everybody's making it out to be currently. That's what I'm saying. Like, we have other things to focus on. Everybody's just like, well, fast lasting is cheating, so yeah. And then he posts the comment and then he goes and fakes clips the next second. Like, it's just like everybody's so hypocritical, and it's just really, really annoying.
Yeah. I thought that's why I said it's up to, like, bigger people in the community to set a hard guideline, like, this not allowed.
Oh,
this,
no, we
not allowed
all the time, but people think they can get away with it constantly. And there's so many, like, underrated players that fake so many clips, and they are so fucking good at trickshot. I swear to God, like, I would recruit these guys, but they fake clips, like, all the time. They fake their match bonus, or they'll use EB to hit all their trick shots. They're so good at trickshotting, but they just ruin it. And, like, they'll be like, well, why the fuck is that guy not in SOAR? Why the fuck is this guy not in red? Because he fakes clips. Like, we're not going to recruit him. He fakes clips. Like, and people just don't understand that. And there's a lot of people that don't even know EB exists in the COD community. And they're just like, what the fuck's EB? Like, I don't know.
I've played a few different things. I've played, like, even people that use auto-aim, but it's not like an instant kill. Really weird. Okay. Like, they'll just hit the left trigger and it will find me.
Mm-hmm.
And then it doesn't even always kill me. I'll outgun them sometimes too, and it's surprising. But then you'll find the people that, you know, just shoot a random shot and three people die on the other side of the map.
Yeah, that's
through nine walls.
That is nobody finds that acceptable. Nobody should find that acceptable. And then the excuse people come up with is like, oh, but dude, like, we're just trying to have fun. Like, why the fuck do you care so much? Like, dude, like, what do you mean? Like, you know what I mean?
The fun excuse is a very shitty one.
And
everyone is trying to have fun. Like,
yeah.
It's just because you're doing it doesn't mean you had to cheat to do it. It's
exactly.
It doesn't fall in line there. But no, I can agree that the fast lasting thing is not in this as serious. It's not as serious.
It's not in the same. I wouldn't even put it in the same category. Me.
Yeah, I mean it hurts. I think it hurts. It hurts the game. Anything that can hurt the game.
Right.
From a normal player.
The game as it is.
No, it doesn't. I don't think it does, because it only hurts trickshotters. Like, it doesn't hurt the normal player because they're gonna shoot him anyway. But if
a lot of normal players, though, really fucking hate trickshotters because they say it ruins the game.
So I don't think that's true.
No, a lot of people do. Like, I'll get into games all the time. People are like, trick shotters ruin the fucking game or whatever. Like, you could put trick shotting under a bad category, too.
I think
it depends on what community you're in.
I think it's the attitude. That's what makes it bad. I don't think doing it, because if you do something to clear out whatever thing, like clearing out, I don't put it in a bad category in any way, because it's a normal player playing the game. But if you do something that affects the other team that is just trying to play, any normal player, in a negative manner, that's bad. So modding into the fast last team.
That's fucking horrible. Like, you're just like, fuck! Like, why am I in this lobby? This is fucking gay. Look at this guy. He's inviting his friends to fucking ruin our team and so he can get trick shots. Like, in your community, it ruins, like, you trying to win. And that's
what trying to play. Not even winning. Exactly. Just trying to play.
Not even to win, just to play. And you're not having any fun. And that was my point in the video. Like, yeah, sure. This is probably why, you know, he's pissed and whatever. And then you also have to look at it in the side of the trick-shotting community. This fast-lasting thing, I'm pretty sure, came about because so many people know about trick-shotters that they'll just camp in the back.
Trust me.
Like, you can't even...
They want to get kills, so they'll lay down behind a car on raid.
Or whatever, and it's just like, dude, fuck. So, like, that's where that fast-last thing came about, just so people could have a chance to trick-shot, you know what I mean? But, I mean, there's two different sides of the story every single time. Do I think that fast-lasting is totally appropriate, especially when you're fucking, like, having five people on the other team? No, that's not fucking okay. It shouldn't be okay. But if it's just, like, one person, one or two, it's not a big deal to me, because I'm in the trick-shotting community, and it doesn't hurt the clip at all, like, whatsoever.
The shot is still there.
Exactly. When trick-shotters, when we think of cheating, we think, okay, well, how the fuck does this affect the clip? What, does this devalue the clip? What is this? Is it set up? Blah, 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 blah. To me, I see it as it's not cheating because he's still hitting a trick shot on someone that's trying to kill you. To me. To you, you think it's cheating because they're getting to last much quicker and you're just trying to play the game.
No, I think to clarify, it's the clip itself is a normal shot.
Right.
But the problem with it is how you get to the last, how do you get to that shot?
To the compared to the other guy, which is why people put it in a bad category, which I agree with. I would put it in a
Because
bad category, but not in the same bad category as fucking these other things.
It's a scale. There's
and
a
it's
scale.
So bad, which is why I'm saying, like, dude, this is blowing up right now. Moonzy's getting ton of fucking hate for this. I have to make a video talking about this. Like, there's so many uneducated people on this topic, and so many people that are just like, Marksman made a video about this guy. He exposed him. Just fuck him. He should be kicked. What the fuck is this? But they're not putting any thought process into this.
No, they never do.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. I'm just doing my comments on my video, and I'm just, like, getting a headache. I'm just like, oh, my God. Like, I see all these wall of comments with just horrible grammatic errors. Oh, my God, I can't do it. And it's just like, dude, you gotta fucking think right now. Like, it's two different communities talking about the same thing. You gotta see it from both sides, you know what I mean? So, do I think this is, like, okay, like, everyone, it's okay, go ahead and fucking do fast last. No, but if it came down to the point where Moonzy was gonna get kicked for this, no, this is fucking not even, not in the same level.
Yeah, I don't think you should be kicked for it either, because I think it's a simple thing to say, all right, I won't do it, and then you set the right example for the people that are trying. And like I said, the example is what needs to be set, because you need to, like I said, draw the line. Because fast lasting, and people use this example, that their arguments are horrible, but they were trying to compare it to, like I said, clear outs, because, like, oh, you get to last faster with clear outs. You're saying that's against the rules. Like, do you have a fucking mind? Are you kidding me? That's a regular player in comparison to not having four people on the team and basically a team VSAT. And then I compared it to how far can it go? Can I have a modder on my team that kills five people off the bat and then just lets me do it?
That's just fucked up. Like, that would never be allowed. If anybody did that, that is definitely in need of an exposing video. Like, that.
Because it's the same thing. It's like if you have a VSAT all of a sudden because the modder gives it to you, and you have five people on your team that aren't there now.
It's the same thing. Not the same thing, though.
It is. You have five. You don't have any teammates, and then you have the other team has a VSAT. What's the difference?
It's not the same thing because, like, in Moonzy's case, like, or in some other people's cases, they won't, it'll just be like one or two people. Most of the time it'll be two because they have split screen or whatever on the other Xbox, and then it'll get rid of two spots. So then you're left with four more people and you got to kill three people. It's not like they're just fucking gone. If in the same case as that one video you uploaded where there's five different fucking people and then there's that are like fast lasting and then they all just kill themselves and it's just last automatically, that's fucked up. That shouldn't be allowed, and that's just how it is. That's legitimately like locking the lobby, and locked lobbies aren't allowed in Call of Duty. So, I don't know. Like I said when I brought up the 29 lobby free-for-all thing, if this is considered cheating, the 29 lobby free-for-all thing is much worse than this.
But yeah. For a long time, it wasn't allowed either. Like, exactly. Like, I mean, not even in FFA, even in S&D. If it was six-man versus six-man, like, back out. It's another trick shot.
Right, exactly. Can't do it. Then all of a sudden, it just became okay. And I don't know why.
I remember doing it when you have, I have a lot of fake gamer tags to avoid anyone recognizing me for reactions. But I'd have, like a fake phase name, like, oh, it's another trick shot or back out. Mm-hmm. I was like, what?
Yeah. No, definitely.
I made a mistake. So. I should not have made phase my name. can't play them now.
Yeah, no, I'm glad we could talk about this and clear some fucking things up, because yeah, definitely it's good to see two sides of the story and not just fucking one, you know what I mean? So
yeah, there's always two sides to everything. Yeah. And people,
I made the video because everybody, Moonzy especially, was getting a lot of hate from this, and I was just like, dude,
Him too in a quick DM, like he's like, I've been a little rude, and I was like, don't worry about it. I mean, it's just up to you and other people that kind of lead the community. I say lead, but like anyone that's relatively large in the trickshot community.
Totally agree with you. That's why
to
I'm
set the standard.
Right. No, I totally agree with you. That's why before Black Ops 3 comes out, I'm gonna come out with that video that I was talking about. But
yeah, it'd be good. Definitely.
Yeah, for sure. So I'm glad we could talk about this. Definitely cleared some things up for sure. So we both agree that fast lasting isn't as big of a deal, and it's still bad, but it's not on the same level as everything else. So
no, it's not an automatic kill you from across the map through four floors and walls and
yeah, for sure.
Just fall over.
Alright. So yeah, that was a good talk.
So yeah, that was
fucking 30 minutes of talking about fucking fast lasting on Xbox.